Hello friends, so today I'm going to start this educational DP contest from AdCoder. I will upload all the videos one by one, and if you like this video, please spread them and follow with me along this series. And first try to do this question by yourself. I'll tell you how to make the DP table and how to approach the question. If you like my explanation, please hit the like button, and now we'll start the explanation. So we'll start the first one in this video, and then the subsequent videos will have the other solutions. Okay, so in this question statement states that there are n stones numbered from 1 to n, and for each I the height of the stone is hi. So there are actually n stones numbered from 1 to n, and the height of each stone is hi. There is a frog who is initially at stone 1. Okay, he will repeat the following action some number of times to reach the stone n. So he has to reach the stone last one. Okay, if the frog is currently on stone 1, he can jump to stone I plus 1 or stone I plus 2, and the cost is hi minus ht is incurred, where j is the stone he lands on. Okay, now find the minimum possible total cost incurred before the frog reaches stone I. Okay, so we'll understand this with this example. So what you'll do is, let's assume there is a stack of height 10, but I am just writing this with this notation. There is another stack of height 30, then 40 and 20. So the basic thing to develop a DP table is find out what are the constraints, what are the final answer you want, and then as you want from I equal to 0, move till I equal to n and find any pattern. Can you find some pattern? Okay, so let's build the DP table with me. Now first try to build the DP table for the first 2-3 values and then continue the pattern. What you will see is you have to find the cost, only the cost, minimum cost. Okay, if you are on the first stack of stone or the stone, and there is only one stone, so you are at the last stone, you don't have to spend any money, so the value or money you spend is 0. Now take two stones, always make your answer build one by one. Now you have two stones. Now for two stones, if you are on the first stone, you have to jump on the second stone because you have to reach the last stone. So the cost will be the height of this minus the height of this, which is 20. I hope you understand. I'm not using any pattern now, I'm just building on it. Now if you have three stones, what will be your option? Your option will be, you can go either this way, or because you can jump one step stone or two stone, so you can either go this way and this way, because you can jump on this stone and this stone, or you can directly jump two stones. So you have to find out the minimum cost now. So for finding out the minimum cost, does you have calculate this jump value? Yes, so you just have to add this jump value to it. So we have calculated this jump value. The jump of this jump value is 10, and we have to add this. This is 20 plus 10, which is 30. It is either 30, or you can directly jump on it, which is 40 minus 10, it is also 30. So the minimum is 30 only. So what we does is, we look at the back one, add the difference at this point, or look at this one and see the difference. Okay, let's build for one more. Now you have four stones, so you have to reach the last one. You can either go this way, you can jump this and go this way. You have calculated all these values. So for reaching this stone, you have calculated the minimum. Now for reaching this, you can either go this and jump on this stone, you can go like this, and you can go like this. But going like this or going like this, you will reach this stone only, and you have find out the minimum to reach this stone is 30 only, which is like this. So why go like this? If you want to reach from here to here, why go like this? You can go like this directly. So the possible combination is you can go from this to this, you can go here and then go here, or you can go here and then go here. I hope you understand. So the thing is, you just look at the back one and see the difference between them, or two back one. This is the approach in which you are using the values you have already computed and solved your table. The other way can be, make this table. I am only going, okay. Initial one is 0. I hope you understand why the first one is 0. Now, you can go and initialize everything with infinity. You cannot reach anything at start. Now, you can reach at this point, which is 20, at the cost of 20. So, which is less than infinity. So, you can reach this point less than infinity. So, update this value. Update this value, which is always less than infinity. Now, you can also go here with a cost of 30, which is less than infinity. Now, you are at this point. Now, you cannot go furthermore. Now, come at this point. From this point, you can go at this. From 20, you can go at this, which is the cost is 20 plus the difference, which is 30. So, you can reach 30. And because it is not the minimum one, you remain it with 30 only. And you can get here at a cost of 20 plus 10, which is 30. Now come to 40. You can go from 40 to 20, which is 20 plus this cost, 50, which is greater. So you do not update it. The answer, final answer is 30. So you can build on this way and you can also build on this. The final answer is 30, I think so. Yeah. I hope you understand both of the logics. Now I'll code based on this. You can also try this one, but I'll do on the basis of this. So what I'll do is, I have to first take the length of the array. Now we'll take the input for the height. Store all of them in this vector. Now initialize our vector for which we want to fill out our answer as dp size n, make it a very large number infinity. You can like, okay. Now what you'll do is you'll make the first entry equal to 0, which I've told you earlier. Now iterate over I equal to 0 till I less than n, I plus plus for j is equal to I plus 1, j is less than equal to I plus 2, j plus plus, because you have to jump from this position to this position, and if j is less than n, then only you can do this operation. What operation you can do? Dp of j is equal to minimum of dp of j comma dp of I plus the cost, which is the absolute of height of ith point, ith stone and the j. In the end, you have to see out dp of n minus 1. Let's run this. for input. Okay, let's now paste this. Answer is 30. Just correct. Submit this. Running. And accepted. Now I hope you understand the logic. If you still have any doubts, please mention down. Thank you for watching this video, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.